Hello, hello, happy Wednesday. It's Wednesday. Happy Wednesday. Hopefully I can get through this without a lot of coughing. I have a little ugly cold that will not let me be great. So far I've told part one was basically me telling about on the 28th, 2016 of January is when she had her rupture. She was looking normal, acting normal, and all of a sudden she said her head hurt really bad. And then she was on the floor, nausea, got to the EMS. So the EMS was called. They took her to the hospital. They treated her for, they treated her for 7 hours for a migraine. They gave her IV with a migraine cocktail. She was still lethargic. I noticed that a nurse was concerned. As a parent, within my spirit, I was still concerned. But they sent her home. I took her back to the urgent care. The urgent care put her in an urgent care vehicle and took her back over to the emergency room. And that's when they found the blood. They did a CT scan, found a blood on her brain. And there were doctors and specialists in the room. And they prepared me what we know as for the worst. Y'all know how those discussions go. And they sent her over to a children's hospital an hour away. So when we got to the children's hospital an hour away, they put her back on all the IVs and machines and things, and they ran more tests, you know, swelling and stuff like they wanted to check. They did another CT scan to check for swelling, to check for additional bleeding, and, you know, to over at this children's hospital so they can make some additional decisions. But they had already decided they were going to, of course, put her in ICU. One of the specialists said that they think that they should drill a hole. And I really should have looked up that procedure before I started because I can't remember what it is. But they drill a hole down through your skull to relieve pressure and any fluids or anything like that. But in my opinion, God said no. And the procedure didn't happen. Right as they were getting ready to begin, the ICU head doctor, I forgot what she was called, came in and said, she didn't recommend that. So we didn't do it. So they took her on up to ICU. And once there, they, you know, gave us some information about ICU. And this was all new to me because not only had none of my kids had been sick enough to even go to a hospital, you know, to stay, I had never really been, you know, in an ICU or familiar with ICU for children. So from there on, it kind of, the days kind of ran together. Things went fast and slow at the same time. one of the things they were trying to do, and they told me they were trying to do, they said, we're going to bring in a radiologist. We're going to bring in a neurosurgeon. We're going to bring in a neurologist. Some of these in an ICU pediatrician. And they said some of these doctors are going to be adult doctors. Some of them are going to be pediatricians, but mostly adult doctors. So they brought these people in and the thing about being in ICU with a team of doctors is that one doctor is saying this, one doctor is saying that. I'm going to give you an example. The next morning after we got there, they took her for exploratory surgery. And what they did was they ran a line from her groin up through to her brain so the radiologist could get a really good look. And they wanted to shoot some glue up there to stabilize or stop any additional bleeding. And so that was about, I guess, about a 2 hour procedure, I think. Very nerve wracking. and they have to put you under and stop your breathing and put a tube down. And so they did that. And the radiologist came in to talk to me and my parents. Thank God for my parents that was with me the whole time. And the radiologist came in and talked to me and my parents. And he said, now, what I forgot was before they took her for this procedure, I had a little breakdown where I was feeling like they wasn't telling me any information. What is going on? At this point, y'all should be able to tell me why she's bleeding on the brain. And they told me that it was an AVM. And I'm going to give some information on what an AVM is later on. I could barely pronounce the actual word for it. But I'm going to give more information on it. But they told me that it was not an aneurysm, that it was an AVM. And, that is what they wanted to go in and take a closer look at. I'm going to attempt to pronounce this. It's a arteriovenous malformation. Arteriovenous malformation. But they said call it AVM. So they wanted to go in and look at that. So the radiologist came back out after surgery. He said it was too deep in her brain for them to treat it by removing it. That was his feeling. And so they were going to just do this procedure where they like either radiation to shrink it or gamma knife to shrink it. And so I'm confused and I'm trying to go to, excuse me again, I'm trying to go to the internet and find out what's going on. What is AVM? How did this happen? Why did this happen? You know, and one of the things that, you know, encouraged me is that it said that the, for the most part, it wasn't life threatening, but it could be because of the bleeding and swelling, blah, blah, blah. Meantime, her vital signs were very low. Her blood pressure was very low. She was, of course, in and out of sleep. When she was woke, she was crying out in pain because of the pain of having any blood on your brain is very painful. So the headaches and things were painful. So either she was asleep or she was woken very agitated. I have never prayed so much in my life. I mean, I pleaded for my child's life, pleaded for her life. And that's something that still haunts me. And that's something that I have to go to therapy for every once in a while. You know, it's almost like a PTSD when you think back to it, but talking about it helps. So this therapist said this, so let me get on with it. Cause I know I only have 15 minutes. So after the therapist said that, the team of doctors wanted to go back in again because they disagreed with their radiologist. They said, if we can take this thing out, she would have a better quality of life and she can go back to cheerleading. Now, what I didn't tell y'all is that my daughter was a very active student, honor roll student. She had been a cheerleader since age 8 or 9 years old. She cheered all through middle school. So she was a cheerleader starting about 8 years old. She cheered all through middle school. Trying to wait till my recorder starts back. Okay, she cheered all through middle school and she cheered in high school. And at this time, at point when she was 15 in 10th grade. So a very active girl. So they said, you know, let's take another look. Let's go back down, take another look, send some more, whatever that glue is that, you know, stabilize it up there again. So we went back down for another surgery about 2 days after the first, I think it was. And they did that procedure again, a little over 2 hours, very nerve wracking, waiting. So after the surgery, a lady comes out that I have never seen before. And she introduced herself. And I was, by this time, my nerves are so tore up that I can't make a real sound decision. And so she's talking to me, but she's really looking at my mom. And she said, I know that y'all have been told that that AVM is real deep in her brain and you can't get to it. She said, but I've done these cases before. Now this thing, AVMs are rare. Less than 1% of the population have them. And so she came from nowhere, literally. She read this about this case basically on a medical blog or some type of medical social media. I don't know, but she got interested and told them she was coming in from somewhere else. So she looked at my mom. She talked to my mom. She said, this surgery is probably anywhere from an 8 hour to a 10 hour or more surgery. It's a very delicate surgery, brain surgery. And she said, only way I could describe it is it's like you have a piece of jewelry, precious piece of jewelry, and it becomes tangled. And you want to untangle it without breaking it. So that means you have to move very slowly and be very precise and careful. She said, but I can do it. That's what she told my mom. She said, I can do it. She said, well, so what I'm going to ask you to do, you pray and I'll do the surgery. And so we agreed to the surgery. I leaned on my mom to help me make that decision, and we agreed to the surgery. So after about 4 or 5 days of being in ICU, they took her in for brain surgery. Now, I'm going to have to go into a part three, because the day of brain surgery was very nerve-wracking because some events happened that caused my daughter's surgery to get delayed. And the team of doctors, the two neurosurgeons, the radiologists, and everybody who was going to do the surgery had to end up doing an emergency surgery on another child that was in a terrible accident. So they held us back in the back while this was going on. And so they delayed her surgery for about 2 or 3 hours, but they wanted to do it the same day. And my concern was they just been in a surgery and they're coming out of a surgery and they're taking my child back and they're probably tired. But they took her back, and I will tell you, without going into part three, I will tell you my child is fine. She's in college now. She's the one who gave me this cold, but I want to get all of this out so I can bring some awareness, to what could happen and speak to parents about, being an advocate for their child and knowing not only your own body, but knowing your child, you know, what's normal and what's not normal for your child. And I also want to make people very aware of this AVM, since it's so rare and so heard of, and it can be so easily missed because there are actual doctors who are not familiar with it fully. But so I will tell in part three about what events happened before her surgery. It caused her surgeons to have to go into another surgery before hers. And it was an 8-hour surgery. 8 hours waiting. So that'll come in part three. Now, I told y'all yesterday that, or on the 28th, that there was a song all the way to the walk to the car. Only thing I could say was Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And I got in the car and he cranked it up. I was with her dad and he cranked it up and the song Jesus, Jesus, Jesus came on.
Supernatural, special friend.